I'm not signing off just yet. I'll see if there's a secret wall through here. Where am I? I didn't go through anything, right? I went out. Yeah, continuing on this wall. Wait, there's a monster! We found our way through somewhere. We must have. Okay. We found a secret wall. Alright. Whirlwind. Guess what? Episode's not over yet. Unless I'm ending it here. It's gonna be a third episode. Three of four. Something like that. I wish they'd switch up the monster types a little. I mean, it was cool fighting the stone golems. That was a little different. Windhowler. Evolving. Agile deflected. Got two more whirlwinds left in him. I'm gonna err on the side of caution and just heal him. Good. Is it full? One down. Thrash the rest. Oh, nice. Get rid of the second one. Well, they're all going for Nelvin now. This is not good. I don't like when they do that. Attack. 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 Whirlwind. Heal. Awesome. Deflected! Ah, not deflected. Medium again? Yeah. Or anti-magic war. Alright. Now we all miss. Elven 13. Windhowler on him, I guess. 32. Ouch. Medium healing again. much okay. Yeah, just attack, I guess. Gotta be our last round. Not exactly. Close though. That's not Nelvin's, is it? When did that break? When did that break? You still had it here. Okay, I'm gonna play this over. I already had one mage robe break on him. While attacking, okay. Obviously, yeah, I did not see that happen. What is it with the mage robes breaking now? That's a new thing. I'm glad I didn't save it like that. Because I didn't notice until I saw the ruined robe on the ground. In the loot pile. You still have it? You still good? Alright. I think Citrine still has her weapon. We all have our weapons, right? Just making sure, because I'm gonna save it. Like this. We need to heal Nelvin. Is that a magic? Yeah. How about a magical projectile? In your face! Pew! Oh, look at that. They're trading projectiles here. Still need some healing. Just being careful, I don't want to be playing this over and over again. I mean, back in the day, if you were playing this on an actual Amiga, you'd reload the whole fight. Hopefully, you would have saved before so. After this. Okay, now no destroyed robes. Excellent. Right. Oh, there's a switch there. Look at that. Look at that. I found my way through. Just wasn't what I thought it was going to be. It was a switch or a button. In this case, a switch. But not out in the open. Alright, stand by, guys. Okay. Back, obviously. I probably don't have to do this. Well, first of all, I'm gonna save. But I am gonna rest up. We all have a ration, which is good. I don't get stuck and waste another mana potion, magic potion, whatever. Power potion. See if I can cast another one. Create food. Nope. Fail. How about one more time? Yay! So now we should have two. Yep, we will rest twice. I don't think any time has passed, just combat time mostly, so... Okay, so we're at full. I'll cast one create food. Worked the first time. Awesome. And magical. Wait, I think I hit the wrong thing. Magical lantern. Failing. Magical barrier. Magical assault. Failing. I can't do the anti-magic good enough. I should have just saved here in the first place. Just in case something comes out and attacks us, because I don't know what else is in that room. True, there's not room for much there, but you never know. See, let's hit the switch. Kind of wonder what's on either end here. Flick! The way is open. I'm facing south. I'm meant to face north. Oh, right, right. Yeah, the... We came there through a secret... wall. There we go. What do we have? Oh my god! Stairs up. Can you believe it? There's a sixth floor. Yes, I am saving again. Alright, Lebab's Tower 6. Top of the tower. Cool. I wonder if this will be a much smaller floor. Alright, we're going around in both directions. Oh, what's it say? I wonder if there'll be any more encounters. The brass signs, or sign, says, magic spells of all kinds. We can recharge almost any magic thing for you. Really? You can do that? Recharge. Welcome! Do you want to recharge your magical objects? Which item do you want me to enchant? What? We don't have a lot of gold, do we? I don't even know if we need anything. Enchanted. I guess that's when you use like Firebrand has like fireballs in it. But I think we've been saving all that. That was a spell of magical arrows. Moon amulet. Yeah, we don't use this stuff ever, so... We can't recharge a lantern, can we? I'll try. Edgel has one. One? Enchanting this item will cost you 100 gold pieces. Okay. Recharge the lantern. For all I know, it did nothing. I couldn't say. Okay. Well, that was interesting. If you ever need to recharge things, we can climb up this annoying tower again. Are these people, like, trapped up here because they can't get out because of the gargoyles? I mean, they're just hanging out providing services in this death trap of a tower. Huh. Yeah. Merchant. So we came in here, right? Oh no. Back there it was. So this is something else. What's in here? Ah! Hello. Right with you. I just want to take out the dimensions of the room. Thank you very much. Do not back away. I mean you no harm. I said I mean you no harm. Stop sidestepping me. Okay. I know I'm in your face right now. You see a man wearing the robes of a magician. Yes, I do. He's looking into the distance and seems very absent-minded. Hmm. His name is Lebab. Okay, this is his tower. He's 80 years old, is a 50th level mage human. Wow. Oh? Visitors? Customers? Welcome to my tower. It's a wonder that you reached me. You should know that at the moment I am having trouble with a jealous magician by the name of Drek. Edgel starts to speak and says... Okay, I didn't realize we had Edgel as an active character until I saw his name in yellow here when I was looking at Lebab. Dear Lebab, you don't need to worry anymore. Drek is dead, and most of his gargoyles have been destroyed. All of them, anyway. Lebab looks at you for a moment in an irritated manner, but appears to have accepted these facts, for he does not ask any questions, but just says, Oh yes, really? Very interesting. Then I can clear the entrance to the teleporter on the first floor again and switch off the stone golems. Okay, so first floor teleporter. Okay, so we can get up here more easily and recharge our items. Awesome! It was funny because in Amberstar, like, just about everyone responded with hello. And, hello doesn't seem to work anymore. Okay. Let's ask him about Drek. Poor Drek. His greed for power led him to his death. A few years ago, he was my apprentice. But when he pressed me more and more to leave the tower to him, I threw him out one day. Since then, he's been fighting me wherever he can. Hmm. Tower. I built this tower when I found that the magic power is particularly strong at this height. One use for this discovery is the ability to recharge magic things whose power is exhausted. Naturally, no one is evil in any way may gain control of this power. Okay, cool. I wonder if there's anything else he might know anything about. Mage. Does he know about the insane mage? Do you know about any magic words? Oh, that guy in, I forget if it's New Lake or at one of the other places, wanted us to ask about these words. Pears. Thing. Tempest Fugitive. Alright, I guess we're done here. Yes, yes, farewell. Mapping out that corner of the room. And we should be good. Right, we'll leave and continue to the south and see what else might be up here, if anything. There's a teleport field that way. And we'll go around further this way. And a switch. Before I hit this thing, I guess we've made it to 121, wow. I just want to make sure, before I hit this thing. I'm gonna go right up to this. Right, so there's no way through, but if I hit that switch, that will open something. Blink! What did it open? If you open the way into this. I wonder if there's something in here. Let's see. It's no way through it unless from the corridor. I especially wonder what the Look at that. I wonder what the switch opened. Trap discovered and disarmed. Chest has been opened. A scimitar, another wind pearl, some wishing coins, and 5 all healing potions. No one can carry any of this stuff. Oh, and 258 gold. Did I check, did the other chest have gold in it? I forgot to look. You know, I'm willing to think that the switch opened this portion where the chest was. Can't be sure, because I discovered the switch first. Oh. Oh. Go this way. Now I'm wondering, actually, I don't think there'll be anything else through there. Alright. If I press the switch again, does it close? Wait a second. Where am I? Facing up that way. Try to look at it again. I think it won't move. Yeah, it doesn't move. Alright. So let's go through the teleporter. I'll save first, of course. Now we're here, where we couldn't get through before. Sweet. If only we know that maybe the switch opens the wall, we would have been stuck on the other side. Well, we could have gone back up, but maybe the switch opens this way. Maybe there would have been a wall here instead, and it would have gone through and be like, huh, well, can't go anywhere. Back out into the sunlight. Well, not really. It's nighttime. Anyway, I'm gonna call it an episode here. I'm not completely sure if we're going to Sand Freeze or if we're going to that island to the west. Well, there's a few different caves on it. Apparently some fearsome monster roaming about, and a cottage. I think I'm gonna go with that next, because that kind of intrigues me. And then after that, I guess we can take the Windgate to Sandshrees Island. The village of Snake Sign is apparently still there, as well as the dungeon itself. In any case, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.